ADG, I'm glad that you mentioned the cybersecurity issue here, because several countries are accusing China of a massive cyber attack campaign. They're calling it, as I understand, Advanced Persistent Threat 31 or something like that. Are similar tech offensives also being observed in the Philippines?
Yes, we have been seeing more and more challenges. If you remember, a few weeks back, or if not a month ago, the Department of Information and Communications Technology issued a warning to the public that there has been persisting cyber attacks from foreign sources. No? And that is why it is critical for the Philippines to beef up its cybersecurity, not only in the government side, but also on the private sector. The president has given a clear instructions. That is why, for example, in the National Intelligence Cooperation Coordination Agency, NICA, the president issued an executive order creating a new office within NICA for cybersecurity. The purpose really is to prepare us for increased malign influence operations coming from foreign sources, and to prepare the Philippines for more aggressive foreign interference utilizing the cyber domain, which is why the National Security Council is also sounding the alarm on possible electoral interference by foreign entities, because next year, 2025, is an election year. Given that it's an election year, we should be starting to prepare now on how to protect the integrity of the electoral process and protect it from cyber attacks.
Okay, when you say persisting cyber attacks from foreign sources, have we already traced which foreign countries these attacks originate from? Are they just coming from one single country or different foreign entities?
That's a very good question. But I think it is best, Katrina, if you can interview the DICT. They have more details of this matter. But we have expressed to them our concern, and we have also relayed to them that we need to have a robust cybersecurity strategy and to also prepare for the 2025 elections for any possible foreign interference.
Okay, give us an idea with regard to this possible foreign interference during our 2025 midterm elections so that the public can at least be aware of any red flags that they might encounter online. What is actually happening here? What are the breadcrumbs that actually lead you to the idea that there will be foreign interference during the 2025 midterm elections in the Philippines?
Well, we see a consistent pattern abroad. No, we have seen foreign interference in elections in most democracies because, you know, democracies are, of course, by the very nature of the system of government, is vulnerable to cyber attacks. Primarily because of the freedom of speech, you know, and the freedom of speech and the openness and transparency of such democracies. So we have seen foreign interference, for example, in elections in the United States. We have seen foreign interference in elections in Ukraine and in many other democracies in the world. So since it is the responsibility of government to prepare us for any eventualities, and given that we are strategically located in flashpoints in our region, it would be prudent for the Philippines to start preparing for that, no? Ensure that our election database is secure from hacking, ensure that the transmissions of election results, no, are secure and cannot be subjected to any cyber attack, ensure that the campaign process, no, is not interfered with using fake news or disinformation or malign influence. So all of these, no, form part of what is called as threats to our national security. Because if you remember, Katrina, the exercise of democratic rights or the electoral exercise is a pillar of our democracy. So if there is any threat to the integrity of the electoral process. That is a national security interest of the Philippines. That is why we need to start preparing for that as early as now.
Mm-hmm. And based on what you are seeing on the ground, as of this moment, what are the threats that you see online with regard to the possible electoral interference? Is it something as simple as the deployment of trolls, the use of troll farms, or is it something as complex as actually hacking the electronic counting of votes here?
That's right. That is something that should keep our security experts awake at night. No, it could be as subtle as troll farms or disinformation, fake news and disinformation to sway the public to a certain political thought, or it could be as serious as hacking the electoral database or interfering with the transmission of votes. No, for so long, Katrina. We have always been concerned about politicians manipulating the electoral process for their own benefit to ensure their victory. But given the complexity of the geopolitical environment we are in, and given the importance of elections in democracies, and since we have seen in foreign countries foreign interference, no, we have seen in democracies around the world foreign interference, then it would be prudent, as I said, for the Philippines to also start preparing. So I think the COMELEC should be working very closely with us at the National Security Council, working very closely with the DICT and all the agencies of government, so we can ensure that this threat is addressed before it even happens.
Okay, ADG, finally, before we let you go, I'm assuming that this was brought up during your meeting in Malacanang. What's the latest with regard to the Philippines' case buildup against China's environmentally destructive activities in the West Philippine Sea?
Well, both the Department of Justice and the Office of the Solicitor General are pursuing two tracks, no, in relation to possible cases on the environment and other possible cases that we can file, no, but. I think it would be best for you to interview the DOJ and the OSG on this, no? Because this is within their purview and that not within the purview of the National Task Force West Philippine Sea or the National Security Council. But let me just state, Katrina, since we're on the topic, that Secretary Gibo Chudoro yesterday spoke about possible arbitration. And Secretary Gibo was talking about if China really believes its position, then they should file for arbitration under international law. No, because we have done so already. We already filed and we already won. But if they themselves really feel that what they're doing is correct and their claim has historical basis, then they should also file for arbitration. We echo that position of Secretary Gibo Chudoro, and we wish to express to the public that the Philippines is prepared to face China in any arbitration anywhere in the world. We will face them in any court of law, so long as the basis of that arbitration is international law.
And we will have to leave it at that for now. And we look forward to hearing more from you, hopefully with more good news next time. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, NSC Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya.
Thank you for having me.